From the Butler Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, a play-by-play description of the final game of the Indiana State High School basketball tourney is being sent out to radio listeners by 28 sports announcers representing as many stations scattered over the state. All those fans without tickets throughout the state of Indiana are today turning to their radios to hear the details of the tournament. Four teams have come down the long road of 64 sectional, 16 regional, and four semifinal tournaments on their way to this 37th annual state tourney. It's being played the 20th day of March, 1948, before the usual packed fieldhouse of 15,000 excited spectators. The teams for the first afternoon game have left the dressing rooms, and here they are. Muncie is the first to come on the floor, and for the Bearcats, we have Captain Bob Newton, Connie McRae, Homer Bradburn, Fred Powell, Bill Taylor, Kenny Delk, Marion Acton, Joe Gettinger, Ted Harris, Paul George, and Coach Art Beckner. And for Evansville, Gene Southwood, Donnie McDowell, Walter Vanover, Joe Schwitz, Houston Clark, Jimmy Baker, Gene Brooks, Al Sudheimer, Dick Burdett, Lee Hamilton, and Coach Walter Riggs, who has chosen to start the ball game, Gene Southwood and Walter Vanover at forwards, Lee Hamilton at center, and Joe Schwitz and Donnie McDowell at guard. For Muncie, Coach Art Beckner will start Marion Acton and Bill Taylor at forwards, Fred Powell at center, Bob Newton and Homer Bradburn at guards. A last-minute pep talk, and both teams come onto the floor. There's the whistle and the ball's up. The game is on. The tip is taken by Evansville. Joe Schwitz, a long shot from the center, and it's no good. The rebound is taken off by Vanover, who is hurried on a hook shot and misses. Bob Newton picks it up for Central of Muncie. Acton drives in for a shot and misses. The rebound, a long one, goes to Schwitz. Southwood's shot is blocked by Powell. A shot by Schwitz and a Muncie foul is called on the rebound. Evansville does not convert, and in action not shown, Fred Powell scored the first field goal of the game, and Muncie leads 2-0. We pick up the play with Evansville throwing the ball in. A pass into Hamilton, and the shot is way off. Schwitz shoots, and Muncie takes the rebound. Acton drives in, guarded by Southwood, and is fouled. The first free throw is good. The second is in two, and it's 4-0 Muncie here at the start of the ball game. A pass to Hamilton. Up, no good. Hamilton again, and it's in. So it's 4-2. Fred Powell, the center, shoots and hits from the corner, making it 6-2, Muncie Central. Homer Bradburn scored an action not shown, and Muncie leads 8-2. Schwitz takes a long rebound, drives in, and hits. And now it's 8-4, Muncie. A pivot shot by Bill Taylor, one by Powell, and he is fouled. He gets two shots. First one is good. The second is up and in. Now the Bears come down the floor. The pass is to Hamilton. It's intercepted by Taylor. They're keeping two men on Hamilton. Another shot by Powell from the corner. It's in there, and the Bears call timeout, with Muncie leading 10-4. Come on, fellas, pleads yell leader Shirley Lane. However, on the other side of the floor, the story is different. But now our little Evansville cheerleader seems a bit more encouraged as we pick up the game with the score 23-17. The Bearcats still leading. From far out, a long shot by Walter Vanover. It's in and out. Rebound taken by Delk. A beautiful hook shot by Powell in there. And Muncie leads again by 8 points. It's 25-17. Hamilton feeds to Vanover. A shot. It's wide, and the rebound is taken by Kenny Delk. 1 minute, 40 seconds to go in the first half. A long shot by Newton, and it's perfect. A nice shot by Bob Newton makes it 27-17. There's a foul on the way in, and Southwood gets one charity toss. His shot is good, and it's 28-17, as Gene makes his first score of the ball game. Newton in the corner travels, and the ball goes to the Bears. Dick Burdett is now in the ball game for Southwood of Evansville. A wild pass, but it's saved by Donnie McDowell. Now McDowell takes a shot from the corner. It hits the rim, and Newton gets the rebound for the Bearcats. A push shot by Newton is short, but he draws two free tries. His first one, off the back of the rim, no good. The second is up and in, and it's 28-18. A big 10-point lead for Muncie Central. Powell scores two more points for Muncie just before the half ends, 30-18. With their pregame favorites 12 points behind, the Evansville cheerleaders are really in there pulling now. There's the second half tip. It's taken by Central of Evansville. Joe Schwitz tries a one-hander and misses. It's finally taken by Connie McRae, and he's fouled. He eyes the basket, pushes it up, and the rebound is off to McDowell of Central of Evansville. Southwood passes under the basket to Hamilton. A shot rolls off, and Newton gets the rebound. Newton in the forecourt to Bradburn. Back to Ray. He just stands there. There's no score in the first few minutes of the second half. We pick it up later with Muncie still in the lead, 33-24. It's the Bearcats' ball with 1 minute and 50 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Acton going in for a left-handed push shot, but it's off to the left, and Southwood is fouled on the rebound attempt. Gene shoots and scores, making it 33-25. But Evansville is still trailing by 8 points with the third quarter nearly over. Bob Newton driving in for a shot is fouled. He tosses it up and misses. He gets the rebound, shoots. It's off to Powell, who tries. No good. Now the Bears have the ball. Under the basket to Hamilton, who shoots, and Bob Newton gets the rebound. With 35 seconds to go, Muncie wants to hold onto the ball until the end of the quarter. Acton drives in, tries a push shot, but it rolls off. McDowell going fast, shoots, but it's too hard. The rebound shot by Hamilton is no good, and the ball goes out of bounds with 16 seconds to play. Dick Burdett throws it in to Gene Southwood. A shot, swish, and Southwood scores with 3 seconds to go in the third quarter. There's the quarter, and Muncie leads 33-27. We find the Bears now trailing only by 2 points as we pick up the play at 34-32 in the last quarter. Southwood drives in, pushes it up, and in. And the ball game is tied up at 34 all. Under the bucket, it goes to Newton. He takes a shot, and the rebound is off to Lee Hamilton. Now Dick Burdett under the basket. An easy shot. And it's in. And Evansville Central takes the lead for the first time, 36-34. A pass to Ray. A shot. It's short. Hamilton gets the rebound again. Lee has been working well under the Muncie bank board this half. Southwood in the corner to Hamilton, and a foul is called on Muncie. Hamilton eyes the basket. It's up and off to Southwood, who tries one-hander and misses. Now Muncie comes down the floor. Under the basket to Ray. It's up, in and out. A deflected pass is grabbed by Newton, and a foul is called on the Bears. Oh, no! It's up and in, and now Evansville leads by only 1 point, 36-35. To Hamilton, to Schwitz, a beautiful play. Schwitz drives in fast and scores on a pass off by Hamilton, and the Bears lead by 3 points. Pass into Powell, a hook shot, no good. Southwood takes the rebound. Joe Schwitz shoots from far out, but it's short, and the long rebound goes to Marion Acton. Shot from the side by Bradburn is short. The ball goes out of bounds, and it'll be a jump ball. It's up, and Newton takes it. Acton driving in, steps on the end line, and it's out of bounds for the Bears. Two minutes, 30 seconds to go. Donnie McDowell just stands there, daring a man to come out after him. Evansville now playing a possession game, trying to work it in for a good shot. There's Joe Schwitz on a clever jump shot, hits, and makes it 40-35. Bradburn going under for Muncie is all tied up by McDowell, who does a nice defensive job. Up they go, taken by Southwood. One minute, 40 seconds to go, and Evansville has a 5-point lead. There, Hamilton drives in and makes it look easy. Muncie loses the ball when a long pass is deflected and intercepted. It's 42-35, Central of Evansville leading, and determined to keep possession of the ball. Hamilton drives in, scores again, and is breaking the game wide open. It's tough on Muncie after leading for three quarters of the game. Marion Acton shooting from far out. It's no good, but Fred Powell tips in the rebound. One minute and 2 seconds, and Evansville is protecting that 7-point lead. Schwitz passes to Southwood and the whistle blows. A foul on Evansville. Bradburn shooting. It's up and in. On the Bearcats' pressing defense, Hamilton goes under and scores. Evansville leads 46-38. Acton fires a long one from the center circle. It's in and out, but Powell scores on the rebound, and the horn sounds for timeout. Throw in comes to Southwood. There's a foul on Muncie. The Evansville Bears will be the winner in just 15 seconds. Evansville elects to take the ball out of bounds on the foul. They're just holding the ball, not even attempting to score. Seconds left, and they're controlling the ball. 7 seconds, 6 seconds, 5 seconds, 4 seconds. Watch Vanover under the basket. A sleeper shot by Vanover, and it's in just as the gun barks, and Central of Evansville beats the Muncie Central Bearcats 48-40. The Lafayette Rooters welcome their team as the boys come on the floor for the second game. Ernie Hall, Ned Snyder, co-captains Bobby Masters and Dick Robinson, Earl Henniger, Joe Mottram, Bill Kaiser, Charlie Vaughn, Dan Casey, and Jim Lucas. And now for Anderson, Ray Ward, Bob Rousey, Dick Walker, Dan Schuyler, Gene Wilson, Fred Cunningham, Jack Prim, Dick Peck, Arno Land, and Russell Smith. Coach Keith Lambert's starting lineup for the Indians will be Dan Schuyler and Gene Wilson at forwards, Dick Peck playing center, and Bob Rousey and Ralph Smith as guards. And for Lafayette, Coach Marion Crawley is starting Charlie Vaughn and Bill Kaiser forwards, Ernie Hall at center, and Bob Masters and Dick Robinson at guard. The tip-off, and it's taken by Wilson of Anderson. Bob Rousey with the ball. A pass to Wilson, and he makes the first basket of the game. Anderson leads 2-0. Pass to Masters, but he carries the ball out of bounds. It's Anderson's ball. There's Smith going all the way. The bounce pass to Wilson. Over to Rousey. It's a miss, and the rebound is taken off by Bill Kaiser. Now Kaiser gets a shot, but it's short, and a foul is called on Lafayette. In a scene not shown, Peck scores a free throw for Anderson. Vaughn driving under the basket, passes to Masters. It's up, and Hall is fouled in the rebound. He draws one free throw, and it's now 3-1 Anderson. Rousey with the ball, down into the free throw circle. He gives it to Wilson, a shot, hits the rim, and the ball goes out of bounds. Schuyler into Smith. It's up and way over. Now Schuyler shoots, and the ball goes out of bounds. Schuyler again to Smith, a shot, and he's fouled. He'll draw two free throws. Here's a second one. In, and it's 4-1, the Indians. Robinson has the ball for Jeff, dribbles laterally across the court. Passes to Masters, Masters to Hall, and he's fouled on his drive under the basket. Hall gets one free throw. The score is still 4-1 in favor of the Indians. Smith dribbles down the court. Over to Peck, it's good, and a foul called on Lafayette. Peck draws one charity toss. It's short, off the backboard, and out of bounds. Anderson is leading 6-1. In this first quarter of the ball game, Vaughn with the ball, shoots and misses, and the ball goes out of bounds. Skipping now to the end of the first quarter, Anderson has piled up 13 points to Lafayette's 5. Anderson comes down the floor, and the Indians, beaten by Lafayette during the regular season, now are a surprising 8-point leader here at the state finals. Pass goes to Schuyler in the corner, a set shot. The rebound taken by Wilson. Rousey driving in, jumps, shoots, but misses. Joe Mottram grabs a loose ball and heads for the basket, and shoots. A tip by Hall is in, and Anderson calls timeout with a score, 13-7. Time is in, and Smith starts down the court. Masters steals the ball. Come on, Bob. And Masters scores, making the count 13-9. Jeff is beginning to narrow the gap. Their fast-breaking, hard-driving game is typical of real Hoosier basketball. Rousey sets and shoots. No good. A bad pass to Masters, but he saves it. He shoots and is fouled on the play. Bob will draw two free throws. The toss is good, and the score is 13-10, with the Indians leading by 3 points now. The Lafayette rally hasn't dampened the spirit of the Anderson cheerleaders, though. At the beginning of the second quarter, the score is still 13-10, Anderson. Montrum to Masters. The shot is perfect, and it cuts Anderson's lead to 1 point. Rousey takes the ball down the floor. Over to Smith, and out of bounds, it's Jeff's ball. Masters into Robinson, who dribbles down the court. Mottram is checked off by Walker, passes back to Vaughn. The ball is worked cross-court. A pass to Masters. A right-handed shot. It's good. And the Broncos are ahead for the first time in the ball game, 14-13. Bob Rousey has the ball. He tries a one-handed shot. It's short. Shot by Vaughn. Off to the right. Vaughn was fouled on that play, and he'll draw two shots. First one is good. It's now 15-13. Jefferson leading. Second one bounces off the hoop. Now skipping to the middle of the second quarter, the score has climbed to 19-18. The Broncos still ahead. Walker tries a long shot. It's short. But Wilson throws it up and in on the rebound, and the Indians are ahead again. The lead has been going back and forth, back and forth. A pass into the pivot is deflected, but the Broncos recover. Vaughn gets a shot, and it's in. Now Lafayette is ahead, 21-20. Rousey dribbles the ball all the way under, over the hoop to Peck, it's up and in. And there's a foul on the play, and Peck will draw one free toss. It's good. The Indians now lead by 2 points. A bounce pass to Mottram. It's up, good, and the score is all tied again, 23 all. The score remained tied for a few minutes, and we pick up the play near the end of the second quarter. Mottram from the corner shoots and misses. Peck grabs the ball. There's a long pass to Rousey. One-handed push shot is good. Anderson is once again ahead, 25-23. Vaughn on a quick pivot shot. The ball's off the rim. Mottram gets the rebound. Pass to Vaughn. There's a long shot. Wilson takes the rebound for the Indians. Ball goes over to Rousey. A high, long shot. Misses. Wilson picks the ball again. It's up and in, and the Indians now have a four-point lead. After a timeout, it's Jeff's ball. Pass from Robinson to Hall under the basket. A pivot shot, too high. Rebound is in. It was thrown in by Casey of Lafayette. We pick up the game at the beginning of the second half. Jeff is leading 33-29. There's a tip, and it's Anderson's ball. Smith fakes, passes to Wilson. It rolls off the hoop. Picked off by Kaiser. A pass to Hall. And down to Vaughn under the basket. A quick shot, too high. Wilson gets the rebound. Smith tries a jump shot from the foul line. It's off its mark. Casey picks off the ball. The pass to Hall. He pushes it up. No score. Rousey brings the ball down the floor. A long push shot, and it bounces off the rim. Wilson grabs the rebound. A jump shot misses. Wilson is fouled. He'll get one shot. It's off the side. Ball goes to Kaiser. Over to Robinson. There's a long high shot. The rebound goes to the Indians. Neither team has scored in this first minute and 10 seconds of the second half. But picking up the play later in the third quarter, Lafayette is leading 40-33. Jeff has the ball. Mottram tosses one. Too hard. Masters tries one. It misses two. A foul is called on Lafayette, and Schuyler gets his first scoring opportunity. It's good, and the score stands 40-34 in Lafayette's favor. Robinson to Hall. A quick spin shot is good. Hey, where is everybody? Now Krim gets the ball. He loses it. Referee calls traveling on the play. Masters dribbles down the court. Into Hall. A hook shot. No good. Krim gets a rebound for Anderson. Ward drives all the way in, shoots, it's good, but he was fouled on the way and the basket does not count. Ward shooting. It's off the backboard to Robinson. A pass to Masters, shot from way out is in and out. The Jeff cheerleaders who wowed them at the state finals with that new look provoke a Lafayette yell with the Broncos in front 44-34 at the start of the fourth quarter. Into Hall, a pass off to Robinson, and it's good for 2 points on a clever play. Peck, on a pivot, sinks the ball for Anderson, and it's 46-36 with Lafayette out in front. A fast pass to Mottram. He tries a long one. It's off the rim to Schuyler. Walker has the ball. A high shot. Way short, and Jeff takes possession. Over to Robinson. There's a shot, but no score. The ball goes out of bounds. There's a toss by Casey in and out and back in again. It's 48-36, a 12-point lead for the Broncos. A long shot by Walker bounces off the rim. There's a foul on the play. Casey will get one shot. It's up and short. Back to Casey. A quick push shot. Short again. It's taken off by Peck of Anderson. There's a pass to Schuyler. A long push shot. It bounces off into Wilson's hands. He pivots and scores. And now with only a minute left in the ball game, Jeff is leading 58-48, a big 10-point lead. Schuyler has the ball for the Indians. A bounce to Wilson. It's up and short. Foul is called on Lafayette, and Cunningham will get one shot. There it is. No good. The Broncos recover. Mottram drives down the floor, shoots, and misses. In the scramble for the ball, a foul is called on Anderson, and the Broncos will get one charity toss. Here it is. It's up and good. Schuyler dribbles into the corner and tries a long jump shot. There's a foul on the rebound. Here's the Bronco toss. It's good, making it 60-48. Schuyler passes to Wilson. He shoots. It's no good. Another try is off. There's a rebound scramble, and the second afternoon game is over. The Broncos of Lafayette Jefferson have defeated the Indians of Anderson, 60-48. In the evening game, the fast-moving Lafayette squad also defeated the Bears of Evansville Central and thus became the 1948 basketball champions. Now the players receive individual awards from members of the Indiana High School Athletic Association Board of Control. First gold rings are presented to the victorious Lafayette players by J.W. Obrecht. President Harold McSwain of the Board of Control presents the championship team trophy to Lafayette's co-captains, Bob Masters and Dick Robinson. C.B. Simpson sees the Evansville Bears receive their individual runner-up silver rings. Herman M.J. Prague presents the runner-up trophy to Central of Evansville's captain, Gene Southwood. Lee Hamilton of Evansville Center receives the Arthur L. Trester Award for Mental Attitude. Paul Stangl presents the medal as Lee's coach, Walter Riggs, looks on. Lee's father is especially proud because this coveted award is based upon athletic ability plus academic and citizenship records during his high school career. And with the presentation of this award, another outstanding Indiana high school basketball season draws to a close.